All of these zeros and ones and strange number combinations. What does it all mean? Today I'm going to teach you how to read binary, how to understand basic IPv4 addressing structure, and how these two things are intertwined. If you're watching this video, you may have seen binary before, in movies or on TV, but you may not understand the full scope of how it all comes together. The internet functions on what are known as layers. Within one of these layers, communication is understood as either on or off, like voltage. This also occurs within your home computer. And that's where binary comes in. Your zero indicates to the computer or other devices that this bit is turned off, and a one indicates the opposite. This bit is turned on. So what do I mean by bits? A single digit in binary is known as a bit, and a collection of eight of these is known as a byte, or an octet when we're discussing IPv4 addressing. When you look at an IP address, you may notice that there are four sections separated by periods. Each section is represented by a numerical value, not to exceed 255. That's it. 255 is the highest number you will ever see in an IPv4 address. Well, with the exception of most TV shows, where it's just a free-for-all, and anything having to do with computers or hacking typically makes no sense whatsoever. So what does all of this have to do with binary? Each one of the four octets has been translated from binary to display that numerical value you see in front of you. In my example, I'm using a very common internal address. Often you can use this one or something similar, 192.168.1.1, 1.2, etc., to access a graphical user interface, also known as GUI, via your browser to modify some basic settings on your home router. I've added the binary version of 192.168.1.0 here to give you a visual. The one thing you may notice is that the final number, the 0, is consistent when translated into its binary counterpart, 0000000. Okay, so here's where it gets a bit more complex. Utilizing different combinations of zeros and ones results in different numerical value translation. Your first 0 equals 128. The second 0 equals 64. The third, 32, fourth, 16, 8, 4, 2, and the last one is equal to 1. If you're going in this direction, you'll notice each bit doubles the value of its predecessor. This may help you remember this number scheme. So, when they're all turned off, you have 0. But what happens if we turn on this first bit? Now our numerical value for this octet changes to 128. In order to get the 192, the first number in our collection of four octets in our IP, we need to turn the second one on as well. 128 plus 64 equals 192. For our second octet, we have 168. To start, we would turn on our first bit, 128. However, if we turn on our second bit, like the last time, the 64, our value is then too high at 192 again. We'll leave this one turned off and turn on the next one, the 32. So let's see. 128 plus 32 equals 160. Okay, we're getting warmer. Do you remember which bit represents the number 8? If you chose this one, the fifth bit, you are correct. We'll also turn this one on, so 128 plus 32 plus 8 equals 168. Boom, second octet complete. You're a pro at this. The third octet is pretty straightforward. 0000001 equals 1. And the last one, if you recall, remains completely turned off with 8 zeros. So here it is. Our example IP translated completely into binary. Now you can read it, and you're starting to think like a computer. Thank you so much for your time today, everyone. If there's something you would like to learn that I've yet to cover, please drop it in the comment section. I am really passionate about this stuff, and I'm open to teaching anything you're interested in within the scope of my knowledge or experience. And as always, if you enjoyed this video, please like, share, and subscribe. Bye for now.